Oh, and land here? I didn't mean to do that. Ow, that's fine. Let's go to fall, shall we? Best season. Best season. Plus, also, once the water refills in here in fall, I think we can go up back up and talk to Naughty, finally. Our boy Naughty. So, are the beavers, like Beaver Bother Beavers, from Donkey Kong 64, also developed by Rare, were those also called Naughty? I think they were, right? So, those are actually Donkey Kong 64 Donkey Kong characters, so they were in Donkey Kong Country too, as well, weren't they? Or am I crazy? Because I really can't remember. I do love Donkey Kong, but it's not anywhere near like one of my favorite franchises. It's not even, I don't even know if there's a Donkey Kong game in my top 10. Beer get eerie, more caterpillars need 10 this time, because I'm a big boy with big needs. Big needs? Why did I phrase it like that? That's weird. Look at how big these freaking clap traps are now. Or I don't know if that's what they're called, but big boys. They're big boys in the fall. But yeah, the fall adds these like leaf piles that you can climb up. Oh my god, did I ever tell you guys the story of when I So I broke my nose when I was a kid. It's the only time I've ever broken anything. I broke my nose one time. It healed up perfectly well. I didn't actually even need to go to the doctor or anything, but and it's not crooked, surprisingly. But I broke my nose jumping into a pile of leaves. I was like probably 4 or 5 years old, and we had a pile of leaves next to a picnic table outside of our house, and I jumped off the top of the picnic table and landed face first into a like a rock or something, or like right into the ground. Like I just sank through the leaves. I guess the pile wasn't fluffy enough or something. I don't know. I didn't assemble the pile very well and ended up smacking my face on the ground. It's not the only time that happened. I actually broke my nose. I don't think I broke my nose on that one, but it hurt a lot. The one time I did break my nose, though, we had this hill in our backyard that went down. I was talking about a treehouse earlier. The closest thing I got to a treehouse was this, little custom playhouse that my grandfather built. And so we had this little playhouse, and it was made out of, like, solid wood. And it was at the bottom of a hill in our backyard. And I remember being really, really young and thinking it was a good idea to slide face first down this dirt hill. And I did. I went and like leaped and slid down and smacked my face, of course, into the wooden beam. God, that was painful. Man, you know, I think those events are what kept me safe going forward. Like, I was so apprehensive of doing anything after that, anything. So I stayed inside and played video games for years instead. I've been waiting months to give you this. Well, thanks, Naughty. You're not so naughty after all. Rewarded me for freeing his house. Love it. Thank you, bro. Appreciate you. And you got some notes for me, too. Oh, that's cute. Thanks, Naughty. Now come to bed, Naughty. It's time for us to get naughty. No, I already made that joke. We can't be sexualizing this children's video game, okay? Just stop it. Just stop. Cease. Cease and desist, Jepson. I love how it keeps the music from his place underwater. Until you go back into the level up here. Alright, I do believe that is all of the notes inside of those clappy trappy guys. Hey, our boy! Oh, you're awake! You're still here, dude! Has he been sitting there? How many months has he been sitting there? Like 3 or 4 months? What the hell, dude? Excuse me, big butt. Get your big butt out of the cutscene, sir. What is the bull doing? Look at him! He's just like running into the... Hey, and we got a Jiggy.
Right, that's it. I'm off to the lava world.
The lava world? You'll never find me there. I mentioned it earlier, but there was a lava land planned for this game, and I think it ended up getting moved to Banjo-Tooie, which does have a lava world, so. Orange Jinjo for me. Orange Jinjo for you. That's how they make orange juice. They squeeze an orange Jinjo. They don't call it orange Jinjo juice, though. Oh, Jinjo juice! Now introducing brand new Jinjo juice. It's like the in-universe energy drink. I just made that up. That doesn't exist. Get on it, Rare. Rareware. I love this level, but it also takes, like, exponentially longer than the other levels, playing it casually at least. Because you kind of have to go through the level 4 times. And you kind of want to go to, like, every area and see all the things, like... Ouch. Like, you can't transform into anything with Mumbo in summer or fall. But he's there. So, we gotta go talk to him. We gotta go see what our boy is up to. He's got a worm for us. Thanks, buddy. Mumbo busy. Sweet many leaves. No magic today. Okay. Why not? How long is it going to take you to sweep the leaves, huh? Huh? At least you've got some notes. At least it's not totally wasting my time by coming to your home. Some notes. 69. Nice. Nice. Excuse me. Where's the door? Camera. 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 Bum, 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 bum. I realized when I hit record today, playing Banjo-Kazooie, I realized I'm completely fresh out of Banjo-Kazooie facts. I was like racking my brain before this. I was like, what am I going to talk about in today's Banjo-Kazooie episode? And I realized I am both out of Banjo-Kazooie facts and personal stories when it comes to Banjo-Kazooie. I have exhausted all of the things. We've talked about a lot in this series, and it's been really interesting because I've also learned some new things from comments, and I've been able to share some stuff that people have never heard of, and we're just like... Like, the Banjo fan community is just wonderful, man. That's like what I've come to realize through doing this series. I mean, I always knew it was wonderful, but it's just nice to get a little reminder. Every once in a while. No, I don't know if I've mentioned this yet, but have you guys ever heard of crowd control? They just now announced today that they're doing a Super Mario Sunshine crowd control, and they already have a Banjo-Kazooie crowd control. Essentially what it is a Twitch extension that allows people to pay money to activate effects for you in the game. So things like take away your lives, or make you jump randomly, or spawn in items, or like, what, you know, like things like that. It varies from game to game, of course. Excuse me. Hello? Anyone home?
Nothing in here for you now, Bear. We've all moved out.
You mean I murdered all of you? I ended the bee population except for the one guy. Oh, wait, I wonder, can you kill this guy too? If you can reach him, can you kill him? I've never tried. Let me see if I can peck him out of the sky. Oh, I totally can. Hold on. This is gonna be so messed up. I'm sorry, B. You don't deserve this life. But I totally can hit you if I time it right. Wait for him to come back. No, okay, I give up. See, now he comes close and God damn it. I'm sure somebody can. Send me a clip on Twitter of somebody murdering that bee. I just want to see if it's possible. It probably is. If he comes close enough to you. I've never done that before, though. Were you guys lucky enough to have a tree house as a kid? I always wanted one. I got pretty close with that like playhouse that my grandfather built. It was really tiny, but He wasn't in a tree. I always wanted it to be in a tree. But that costs some, like, money. Like, I didn't realize how much money that would have costed until I was an adult, you know? Kids do not understand the concept of money. But were you privileged enough to be awarded a... Oh, Jesus. Wow, that was actually really close. Camera kind of screwed me up a little bit. That's why I want to zoom it out here. Hey, Nabnuts! Nice! Dude, you're looking good! Looking trimmed, man! Looking buff! Been working out, looking for those seeds, man! Yeah, I'll find you some acorns, I guess, since you are lazy now. You're like, I've been working out all summer. It's time for me to rest while you do the work for me to find the acorns that are right in front of my face. But God, these have the worst hitbox. There we go. The worst hitbox, I'm telling you. The worst. That's the only challenge with collecting these. Careful. Careful. Look, I am in it. Kazooie is kissing it. All right, well, we gotta get this one. I almost forgot. Jump. Oh, come now. Just be careful. God, this is so nerve-wracking too. Especially if you get here with low health. This is a really easy place to just perish. You know what? I'll give you a little tip. If you come on this side, you can jump this way. And you can also, remember, you can center the camera behind Banjo with R. And then... I've gone through it how many freaking times now? How many times have I touched it? Many! Many times now! I've touched the nuts! Thank you. I guess they're not nuts, they're acorns, but... I just wanted to say I touched the nuts. Also, I love how we have to go in his house to collect one of the nuts. Look at this. Like, why can't you just go in your own house to get the nut? Sorry, I keep calling it a nut. It's not a nut. It's an acorn. Oh, no. I don't want to turn those in just yet. I got one more to get. And it's up in here. This is new. This is a new little area. So I wonder who's been building all of this whole time. Has it been Nabnuts? Is Nabnuts going out of his way to build a treehouse and stuff? Or is it some mysterious benefactor? I love how he has a pool room now. Like, imagine just having an indoor pool in a tree. I love this. I'm really attracted to little indoor areas in these video games. I really enjoy they seem so cozy, you know? Seems so cozy. I'd curl up there and sleep. By the way, I didn't mention this earlier, but there is a stop and swap item in this level. Yippee! That's all the acorns I needed. Here, take this. I'll see you in spring. Woohoo! Oh, bye. He just pushed me. Rude. Hey, let's go see what he says after you turn in the things. A lot of dialogue in this level. A lot of interesting characters. Yay, there we got his nuts. I keep calling him nuts. It's because his name is Nabnuts. He's nabbing the nuts, dude. Excuse me. You don't want to talk to me? Really? Can I be on your head? Here, I'm just going to sit on your nuts. All right, moving on. Next thing. Let's go feed Eerie. Let's go feed our boy. Our baby boy. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh no. 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 Nope. Get over here, you big clucker. Don't. Okay. I just had to be stern with them. Cluck off, you big cluckers. All right, there we go. Winter is ready. You know, I don't mind winter. I really don't. But having grown up in southern Maine, which is like, it gets pretty cold in the winter in Maine. Southern Maine, not too bad. Northern Maine, probably way worse. But I don't miss like getting up and going to school in the snow. I don't miss that part about it. But I do miss like the quiet of like a blanket of snow and like a light snowfall. And you go out and like I used to live in the woods, right? So it'd just be like really quiet and calm. And you just hear like a light, because it dampens all the sound. Like the snow dampens all the sound in the woods, so you don't hear anything. Especially if you're far away from the highways and stuff like that, you just hear like a light breeze and some like light sounds from snow falling all around you. And I love that. I miss that about winter. Where I live now, we don't get like a lot of snow in the winter, and it's really just like the crappy snow that causes people to slip and fall and spin out their tires on their car. And it lasts like a week, and then it's all just muddy and gross after that for the rest of the winter. It's the kind of winter we get here. And that's the rest of my feathers. All right, I don't believe there's anything in here in fall. There is, oh wait, I just realized something. Okay, good. I just realized something I almost forgot, but I'm glad that I jumped off where I jumped, because was able to land here in order to get this. Almost forgot this jiggy. I tend to forget this jiggy quite often. And I get to the end of ClickClock 1, I'm like, there's the one jiggy I'm missing. How did I miss one? But that's always the one that I forget, because you activate it so early and then you have to climb the tree to get it. And then you collect a bunch of stuff on the way there. And by the time that you've done all that, my already bad memory got, well, that was weird. My already bad memory just continues to be worse. It doesn't help that I also have a pounding headache today. I don't want to get into my like personal health issues at the moment, but I don't know. I just have a massive headache today. I hurt my shoulder this past week filming a little bumper skit for TRG Coliseum, which is coming up next weekend as of this recording, and it still hurts. Like 4 days later, my shoulder still hurts. I really, really messed it up. I didn't break anything. I didn't dislocate anything, but I think I sprained my shoulder. And it's just been, it's been really hard to sleep because I can only sleep on one side now, which sucks. But see, like, sorry, hang on. I was gonna pause because this guy's attacking me, but then I realized I want to listen to the sounds in this level. I love how the music and the sound effects really capture that thing that I was talking about, where the snow dampens all the sound. Like everything's a little bit quieter, everything's a little bit like calmer, and I just love this. It's so precious. And then you got, you know, the opposite side of this is, shit, Jesus. You got another winter level on the opposite end of the spectrum, which is Freezeezy Peak with the big bombastic, like Whoville-esque soundtrack. No big cluckers in winter, though. Too cold. Too cold for the big cluckers. It's too clucking cold. Too clucking cold. Jesus, that's hard to say. Clucking cold. Say that 10 times fast. Ah, yeah, see, there we go. Now we have access to the fly pad. But I'm not going to use it just yet. There's a few things I need to get on the ground before we use that. We'll come back. All right, guys. Don't let me drown. This is just like the oily water from Rusty Bucket. This takes double air. Icy water takes double air. Also, at the end of that lake there, there's an extra life that I will not be going for. And I watched my buddy, I watched my friend who was playing it blind. I watched him try and go for it and die with like 80 notes. Sucks so much, dude. Naughty, happy Christmas, dude. Sorry for slashing your peen, dude. I didn't mean to like cut you there. Thanks for the empty honeycomb piece and the jiggy. Now I'm going to leave and try to... Oh my god. Imagine, like, playing this for the first time and forgetting where the hole was. Like, you spend enough time in Naughty's house. Like, fortunately, you don't usually spend much time in there, but imagine, like, you couldn't get back to the... It's so close, too. If you're not swimming quickly. Eekum-bookum. Ha-ha-ha-ha. I love that they brought back Sir Slush in this level, too. It's not a winter level in Banjo without some snowmen laughing at you. Oh, 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 oh. Yo, what's up, Jinjo? Mumbo became a Jinjo. What? No, he became... No, he became a honeycomb. What is this? What are they called? Beehive. You hairy fool. Wow. Way to insult me. I'm going to peck you in the face and take your honey. That's right. What are you going to do about it? Nothing. Nada. All right, now we can fly. Where shall I fly to is the real question. Let me think. You know, honestly, you can do this whole level without flying if you want. Oh, no, you can't. There's actually one thing we do need to get. We need to get this, first and foremost, which you can't get to really any other way. I guess you could jump off the top of the tree there. But there's the Witch Switch Jiggy. That'll be the last Jiggy in the whole game that we collect. There is one other Jiggy at the very top of the tree that you can get in either winter or spring. So perhaps we'll come back for it in spring, maybe? Nah, you know what? I'll get it now. I'll get it now. I got lots of gold feathers, or red feathers. And you can kind of get, like, a neat view of the level that we haven't seen yet. Flying around here. Look at this. Hey, there's the treehouse. There's some notes there. We'll come back for it. This is the Jiggy I was talking about, though. Oh, wait. No, it's not. Maybe it's even higher. Hold on. It's even higher. It's got to be. Can I zoom the camera out while I'm flying? No. You just got to look like straight-up Banjo's booty hole. And also his, like, hollow legs. You can see through the texture in his legs. Weird. It's very, very jank looking, actually. Oh, look who it is! It's Eerie, all grown up! Oh, our boy! We'll go talk to him in a second here. Our boy! Where the hell is this Jiggy? I know it's up here somewhere. Maybe it's higher? Is it higher up? Jesus Christ. Okay, that's as high as I can go. Where the frick is it? What? Oh, there it is. Ha ha! Hi! Honestly, I think a lot of my humor and the voices and sound effects that I produce out of my mouth hole, I think a lot of that comes from playing this game as a kid. All right, let's go talk to Eerie. I'm eager to Eerie it up. Aww. He's talking. What's up, buddy?
Eerie mighty eagle at last. Watch me as I fly into the sky.
His people need him. I'm gonna miss you, Eerie. I just wanna ride you into the sunset. Why can't we ride Eerie and, like, fight a giant pterodactyl or something with Eerie? It would be cool if Eerie came back in Banjo-Tooie and you, like, fly on him to fight a boss or something. I miss the boy. 9 Jiggies, dude. 2 Jiggies left in the whole video game. What a journey this has been. What a journey. And just reflecting on all of this, too, like, I really wanted to do a traditional Let's Play of Banjo-Kazooie because I wanted a more casual playthrough experience before I really go ham with, like, speedrunning Banjo and, you know, playing Banjo-Kazooie mods and doing Banjo-Kazooie crowd control and doing Banjo-Kazooie randomizers. There's a lot of that stuff now that there wasn't before. So the only way that I could really enjoy this game was to play it again and again and again in vanilla mode. or speedrun it. And I didn't want to speedrun it because I didn't want to, like, ruin the casual experience for myself. So this is the definitive casual gameplay for me before I learn all the tricks and stuff for speedrunning. So this is, like, a really important playthrough for me, you know? And this is something that I'm going to look back on in years and be like, oh, man, remember when we talked about this and remember these stories? Like, it's going to be really nice to have something to reflect back on years later. And so I put my all into this series from a commentary perspective, from a design perspective, from a quality perspective. I think this is one of the better Let's Play series I've ever done. And I'm very, 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 very happy that you guys are enjoying it as well. So check out Nabnut's secret attic. Look at all these acorns and nuts and stuff that he had stored away in the freaking attic. Like, are you kidding me? He made us go out of our way for 6 acorns when he had all this? He had plenty. Like, how much are you gonna eat? Holy cow, dude. Like, actually, you're a cow now. You're not a squirrel, you're a cow. Frick, man. All right, guys, I have something very important to show you. And this is something that I know not a lot of people know about. And I don't know how you don't know, because it's pretty obvious once you look at it. But if you come up here, this is the final empty honeycomb in the whole game. And watch very carefully when I get this extra life on my life bar. It doesn't give you one! This is the max health that you have! 6 empty honeycomb pieces are useless! 6 of them! 3 levels worth of empty honeycomb pieces you do not need! It does not give you any more health on your health bar! Isn't that messed up? Why? Has anyone ever addressed this? Rare! I need to hear from you. At me, dude. As if Rare was, like, one person. Come on, Rare. Mr. Rare. Tell me why. How could you do this? How could you foil my plans for world domination? I need more health. No, I don't. Maybe I do. Maybe I do. Maybe I do. That was so bad. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. How did I do that? What am I doing? Okay, that was karma. That was karma. Oh my god! No! No, what have I done? I did it twice! I did it twice! Twice! And the second time was much worse! Why did I ground pound? Oh no! please, I don't need another incident. Oh, shit. Oh, come on. What? I'll take it. Jesus. This should be the 92, huh? Well, there we go. Good God. Well, that's an extra 20 minutes of my life I'll never get back! Come on, man! I am goddamn freaking over it! I'm over it! No more ground pound. I gotta stop doing that. No more ground pounding. Just flap flippy, flippy flappy. Jesus. Yeah, my best note score, blah, 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 96, yada, yada. The best note score is no longer 92. And I only have 4 more notes to get, and I know exactly where they are. Yes, I know. Thanks, Bottles. You're very helpful. This has taken longer than I had anticipated. Oh, great. Now I gotta deal with this guy. Hey, I never mentioned this before, but Kazooie doesn't slide on the snow. Kazooie doesn't accept ice physics as a thing. So, just keep that in mind if you want to, like, have a little bit more precise platforming here. So that you don't fall off like me. Then you can use Kazooie. Well, that's it. The only other one, the only other thing to get in this level is the Jinjos. And of course, I need to go back and get the purple and green Jinjos again, because I did not get the Jinjo in spring. So we'll go back to spring now, and we'll get that. And go from there. Yeah! I'll get my revenge on these freaking snowmen. Not that the snowmen were even... I haven't gotten hit by a single one of them, and yet somehow still fallen many times. I don't know how that happened. I'm deeply perturbed by the events that occurred. All right, let's go talk to Mumbo. Let's go talk to Mumbo and transform into one of the least useful, but also probably one of the coolest transformations in this video game. I say least useful because you literally only need it for one Jiggy. Exactly one Jiggy you need it for. You can get, there's a couple Jiggies you can get with it, but you only need it for one Jiggy, and it doesn't really do much else besides exist. But it's neat and it's cute. I'm excited. It's adorable. And I've got more than enough Mumbo tokens, that's for sure. I definitely missed like 4 or 5 Mumbo tokens throughout the game, but no biggie. What's up, Mumbo? What you got for me, boy? You found big hidden feature spell? Mumbo turned Banjo into T-Rex? Crush Witch easy? Oh my god, the thing! Except it's not the thing. Changed mind, T-Rex spell too good for this game. Mumbo keep for next game. Did you guys even know that that was a thing? I did, I knew that was a thing. I was hoping, so there is one other secret spell that sometimes Mumbo will randomly turn you into a washing machine, but the even secreter secret spell is the T-Rex, which doesn't appear until Banjo-Tooie. I'm so glad we saw that. It was worth the death just for that. Dude, I would much rather be a T-Rex than a bee. Oh, wait. B-Rex? B-Rex. Now you're thinking with bees. So this is the Jinjo I got before I died. Got him again. The bee, literally, its only power is that it can fly. And because you can fly in winter, there's an opportunity to get that one Jiggy way up high in winter. So the only thing that you really need this for is to access the beehive in spring. That's it. And there's the only thing in there is a Jinjo. So that's why I'm saying it's not that useful. I guess you do get a second Jiggy with it, because you have to use the bee to get the witch Jiggy. That's the real puzzle here. What's up, dude? How y'all doing? I'm just a bee, you know? I'm just a bee, don't mind me. Well, boys and girls, I do believe we've done it. We've officially 100%ed every world in this game, and we have one Jiggy left. We have 99 Jiggies total in this video game. Let's go get the Witch Switch Jiggy for ClickClock Wood, and then we'll go ahead and get the Stop and Swap Egg, and then we are done. And we can go to the end game. How freaking excited are you? I'm so ready for this next part, because the end game of this game is unlike any other platformer. And you will see why. If you don't know yet, you will see why it is unlike any other platformer. And it's so clever and really well done, in my opinion. I know some people don't really like this next section, but I really like this next section. But we'll get to that. Well, I'm getting ahead of myself here. We'll get to that in the next episode, which should be the finale. Whee! Wow, your best note score for this world is 100. Thanks, Bottles. Well, you gotta remind me that I perished. I guess he says that anyway, no matter what. Ten jiggies in the overworld, 10 jiggies in every world, 900 notes from all 9 levels, Grunty's Lair complete, Mumble's Mountain complete, Treasure Trove Cove complete, Clicker's Cavern, yes, Bubble Gloop, Freeze Easy, Kobe's Valley, Mad Monster, Rusty Bucket, Click Clockwood, yes, the only thing left is that Stop and Swap Egg. Oh, bro, let's go. I don't know about this, actually. Can I warp with the bee transformation? I know that Mumbo's gonna transform me, but I don't think I've ever tried to go in the warp with the... Oh, he transforms you before you even get to the warp. Darn. That's okay. All right, we have to head back to Treasure Trove Cove and type in the stop and swap code. So let's go do that now. How bright the... Shut up, Grunty. All right, y'all. Here's the final stop and swap code. Give me a second, because it is going to take me a minute to type it in. But this is actually probably one of the shorter ones, and also very on the nose. So the yellow egg cheat is... Cheat. Now Banjo will be able to see it on Nabnut's table. It's very, very on the nose. It tells you exactly where it is. I mean, it's gonna show you anyway, but. So yeah, let's type this in. T A B L E table. Yeah, there it is. Aww. Oh, I never went in his house in winter, but that he's sleeping with, he's got a lady friend. Yeah. Oh, such a cute little scene. All right, time to break into his house. Santa Claus is here. You didn't have a chimney, so I busted your window. Hope that's okay. There we go. Now we have all the stop and swap items. Not even any dialogue for the final stop and swap item. Disappointment is immeasurable, but they are cute. I love how there's a little pink squirrel now. Acorns. Oh, okay. Well, we're one big happy family now. Mom, Dad, wake up, it's Christmas. Wake up. Well, now that we have all the stop and swap items in the game, what does that mean for us? It means nothing for us. You get nothing. Good day, sir. That is it. That's all. Stop and swap has no uses in the classic version of this game. Of course, in the Xbox Live Arcade version of this game, there are some stuff that unlock in Nuts and Bolts if you get all these things. So if you're playing that version on Rare Replay, then go over and play some Nuts and Bolts now. And Banjo-Tooie, do it. That's your homework assignment. Play Banjo. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching me fail incredibly here in ClickClock Wood. And thank you for watching me collect 100% of the items in the game. There is still more to come, though, because there is an entire end game section. There's also a bonus that we can do towards the end of the game that I will be doing as well. And we'll get to that in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Josh Jepson. If you enjoyed this, please consider supporting over on patreon.com/Jepson, because over there, I'm going to be releasing a Banjo-Kazooie related video this week. It's a Banjo-Kazooie mod called The Bear Waker. I'm going to be doing a one-off video for Patreon. It may come out on the main channel eventually, but it could be a month from now, it could be 6 months from now. So if you want to become a patron and see that video now, I'm trying to get to 50 total patrons over on that, and if we hit that, I will be playing publicly on this channel Jiggies of Time, which is another Banjo-Kazooie mod. Lots of Banjo-Kazooie related stuff coming this year. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Josh Jepson, and I will see you in the next one.